Have you ever watched a movie where your favorite action hero takes a stab wound or loses a limb and decides to burn the open wound with fire to stop the bleeding? Well, cauterizing wounds dates all the way back to the 5th century BC and was wildly popular in the Middle Ages to treat every wound, tumor, and infection on medieval badasses. It makes some sense. When exposed to extreme heat, the proteins in our skin and blood lose their molecular structure and trigger a process called communal aggregation. This is when hydrophobic proteins bind together tightly, disallowing any blood to pass through. And in the case of amputations, applying that scorching heat to an ever-bleeding wound may cause the blood to coagulate, which can hold back the blood flow. The only problem is you'll be left with a second or third degree burn after your daring self-inflicted barbecue. And those second and third degree burns just so happen to be the most ideal place for bacteria to grow, spread, and propagate, and then become infected. Basically, you'll do more serious damage than your original wound may have ever done. So unless you find yourself on set with an open wound as the starring role of the new summer war movie, you may just want to go see a doctor. Hey guys, like this video? Click the link here to see what happens during a sneeze.
As your chest muscles vigorously contract and your throat muscles relax, then out comes the sneeze at 100 miles per hour.
And hey guys, if you like this video, make sure to like and share with your friends.